Good morning, I am Mahalakshmi. We are going to discuss about data structure. The aim of this subject is to help students to design various data structure and application of it and use them in writing efficient programs. A program is said to be efficient when it executes in minimum time and with minimum memory space. In order to write an efficient program, we need to do some tasks that includes activity like data collection, organization of data, and developing and maintaining routines. So data structure is a crucial part for writing an efficient program, and it is our prime concern. The objective here is to introduce the concept of data structure and apply this concept in problem solving. Today, computer programmers write program not only to solve a problem, but to write an efficient program. For this, they first analyze the problem to determine the performance goal that must be achieved, and then think of the most appropriate data structure for that job. The applied data structure may not be appropriate for that problem, then it may result in poor performance, like slow speed of operation. Therefore, the primary goal of a program is not only to perform calculations or operation, but also to store and retrieve information as fast as possible. Be it any problem at hand, the application of an appropriate data structure provides the most efficient solution. A solution is said to be efficient if it solves the problem within the required resource constraint, like total space available to store the data and time allowed to perform each subtask. If the data is not properly organized, then it would look like a garbage disposal. It will take long time to do operations such as insert, delete, search, traverse, etc. For example, if I am asking you to delete 5 chomp chocolate from this arrangement, it will take long time to search this 5 chomp chocolate. After finding these chocolates only, you can delete it. Therefore, data structure is the logical or mathematical arrangements of data in memory. It considers not only the physical layout of the data item in the memory, but also the relationship between these data item and the operations that can be performed on this item. The choice of appropriate data structures and algorithm form the fundamental step in the design of an efficient program. A data structure, therefore, can be defined as a group of data elements used for organizing and storing data. In order to be effective, data has to be organized in a manner that adds efficiency to an algorithm, and data structure such as stack, queue, linked list, heap, and tree provide different capability to organize data. When selecting a data structure to solve a problem, the following steps must be performed. That is, analysis of the problem to determine the basic operation that must be supported. For example, the basic operations like inserting, deleting, searching a data from the data structure. The second one is to calculate the resource limitation for each operation. The next one is to select the data structure that best meet these requirements. The three-step approach to select an appropriate data structure is a problem at hand supports a data-centered view of the design process. In this approach, the first concern is the data and the operation that are to be performed on them. The second concern is the representation of the data, and the final concern is the implementation of that representation. Therefore, Each data structure has its own unique properties and it is constructed to suit various kinds of application. Some of them are highly specialized to carry out specific tasks. For example, stack, a linear data structure which provides last in first out access, is used to store and track the sequence of web pages while we browse the internet. Similarly, B-tree, with their unique ability to organize indexes, are well suited for the implementations of databases. Specific data structures are essential component of many efficient algorithms and make possible the management of large amount of data such as large databases and internet indexing services. Some common examples of data structures are array, linked list, queue, stack, binary tree, and hash tables, which are used almost in every program or software systems. They are widely applied in following areas such as compiler design, operating system, DBMS, numerical analysis, simulation, etc. When you will study DBMS as a subject, you will realize that the major data structures used in the network data model is graph, hierarchical data model is tree, and RDBMS is array. Specific data structures are essential ingredients of many efficient algorithms as they enable the programmers to manage huge amounts of data easily and efficiently. So, data structures are building blocks of a program. Before we see the classification of data structure, we will learn about what is a data. Data means a value or set of values. It specified either the value of a variable or a constant. The example may be a mark of a student, name of the employee, address of the customer, or it may be a constant value of a pi. So a data means it is going to be a value or a set of values. Next one is a record, which is a collection of data item. For example, if you want to maintain a student name, address, course, and marks as a separate data record, then it could be done using a record. A record is the one where all these data items can be grouped together into a single, and we call it as a record. The next one is a file. A file is a collection of related records. For example, if there are 60 students in a class, then there are 60 records of these students. All these related records are stored in a file. Similarly, we can have a file of all the employees working in an organization, or a file of all the customers of a company, or it may be a file of all the suppliers, etc. A data structure is therefore basically a group of data elements that are put together under one name and which defines a particular way of storing and organizing data in a computer so that it can be used efficiently. While one type of data structure may permit adding of new data item only at the beginning, the other may allow it to be added at any position. While one data structure may allow accessing data item sequentially, the other may allow random access of data. So the selection of an appropriate data structure for the problem is a crucial decision and may have a major impact on the performance of the program. Now we can categorize the data structure. The data structures are generally categorized into two classes, primitive and non-primitive data structures. Primitive data structures are the fundamental data type which are supported by programming languages. Some basic data types are integer, real, character, and boolean. As we have already studied in our programming languages like C, C++, Python, and so on. The term data type, basic data type, and primitive data type are often used interchangeably. The next one is non-primitive data structures are those data structures which are created using primitive data structures. Example of such data structures include linked list, stack, tree, and graphs. Non-primitive data structures can further be classified into two categories, linear and non-linear data structures. If the element of the data structures are stored in a linear or sequential order, then it is a linear data structure. Example includes array, linked list, stack, and queue. Linear data structure can be represented in memory in two different ways. One way is to have a linear relationship between elements by means of a sequential memory location. The other way is to have a linear relationship between elements by means of links. However, if the element of data structures are not stored in a linear or sequential order, then it is a non-linear data structure. The relationship of adjacency is not maintained between elements of non-linear data structure. Example includes tree and graph. Therefore, a data structure can be defined as a group of data elements used for organizing and storing the data. And we all know that data structure has its own unique property and it is suited for various kinds of applications. In data structures can be classified into two categories. One we call it as primitive, which is already defined in our programming languages. And the other one is non-primitive data structure, which we are going to be seeing in this subject. Again, non-primitive data structures can be classified as linear data structure and non-linear data structure. Linear data structure is going to be stored in a linear or sequential order, and in non-linear data structure, it is not going to be stored in a sequential order. And we have also seen what is a data. Data is going to be a value or a set of value, and collections of these data item can be grouped into a record, and a file is a collections of related records. We will now introduce some data structures and it would be discussed in detail in subsequent chapters. An array is a collection of similar data elements, which we have already learned in our programming languages. And these data elements have same data type. If it is an integer, then all the elements will be an integer data type. If it is a character, then all the data elements will be character data type. The elements of the array are stored in a consecutive memory location, that is in continuous memory location, and it can be referenced by an index which is also known as subscript. Now we will see one example in C. So array are declared using the following syntax: type, and what is the name of the array, and what is the maximum size it can hold. For example, int marks of 10. So it means that The above statement declares an array mark that contains 10 elements. In C, the array index starts from 0. This means that the first element will be stored in marks of 0, second element in mark of 1, so on. Therefore, the last element, that is the 10th element, will be stored in marks of 9. In the memory, the array will be stored as shown in this figure. Arrays are generally used when we want to store large amount of similar type of data. Here, the limitation is arrays are of fixed size. It cannot be increased or decreased based on the need. Data elements are stored in continuous memory location, which may not be always available. Sometimes, even though we have a space as broken, the continuous memory space will not be available in memory. Insertion and deletions of element can be problematic because of shifting of element from their position. That is, if you want to insert one element in fifth position, then all the element after that should be shifted one position, and then only the element can be inserted. However, these limitations can be solved by using a linked list. A linked list is a very flexible dynamic data structure in which element, we call it as node, form a sequential list. In contrast to static array, a programmer need not worry about how many elements will be stored in the linked list. This feature enables the programmer to write robust program which require less maintenance. In linked list, each node is allocated space as it is added to the list. Every node in the list points to the next node in the list. Therefore, in linked list, every node contains the following two types of data. That is, the value of the node or any other data that corresponds to the node, a pointer or link to the next node in the list. The last node in the list contains a null pointer to indicate the end or tail of the list. Since the memory for node is dynamically allocated, when it is added to the list, the total number of node that may be added to the list is limited only by the amount of memory available. The advantage is it is easier to insert or delete data element. No need to shift element as it is in array. It is enough to change the pointer. The disadvantage is slow search operation, because it always start to search from the first node and then it travels one by one until it reaches the null pointer. And also it require more memory space, as each node will have a pointer to store the address of the next node. A stack is a linear data structure in which insertion and deletion of elements are done at only one end, which is known as the top of the stack. One best example of stack is wearing or removing bangles can be done only at one end. In the computer's memory, stack can be implemented either using an array or a linked list. The stack will be look like this, which is shown in our figure. Every stack has a variable top associated with it. Top is used to store the address of the topmost element of the stack. It is this position from where the element is inserted and or deleted. Stack is called as last in first out structure because the last element which is added to the stock is the first element which is deleted from the stack. A stack supports three basic operation: push, pop and peep. The push operation add the element to the top of the stack, and the pop operation remove the element from the top of the stack, and the peep operation returns the value of the topmost element of the stack. So we have three operation. The first one is push, the next one is pop, and the last one is peep. The push operation is used to add the data element at the topmost position, and the pop operation remove the element from the topmost position. Peep operation just it will return the element at the topmost position. A queue is a linear data structure which is first in first out, in which element that is inserted first is the one, the first one to be taken out. The element in queue are added at one end, we call it as the rear end of the queue, and removed from the other end is called as front of the queue. The elements of the queue are added at one end called as rear, as I said you, and it is removed from the other end is called as front. It has a two basic operations, insertion and deletion. Like stack, queue can be implemented by using either array or a linked list. Every queue has a front and rear variable that point to the position from where deletion and insertion can be done respectively. As I said you, in queue we have a two pointers, front and rear, but in stack we have only one pointer which we call it as top. So we have seen some linear data structure like linked list, stack and queue. Now we are going to see about a non-linear data structure, which is a tree which consists of a collections of node arranged in a hierarchical node order. One of the node is designated as the root node, and the remaining node can be partitioned into disjoint set such that each set is a subtree of the root. So for example, see here we call it as a root node, and it contains a subtree. Each node contains the data element and a pointer for each subtree of the node. The simplest form of tree is a binary tree, I shown here as in figure. A binary tree consists of a root node, a left subtree and a right subtree, where both subtree are also a binary trees. Each node contains a data element, a left pointer which points to the left subtree, and a right pointer which points to the right subtree. The advantage is it provides quick search, insert and delete operations, and the disadvantage is it provides a complicated deletion algorithm. The next nonlinear data structure is a graph, which is a collection of vertices. We call it as nodes and edges that connect these vertices. A graph is often viewed as a generalization of tree structure, where instead of purely parent to child relationship between tree nodes, any kind of complex relationship between the nodes can exist. In a tree structure, node can have any number of children but only one parent. A graph, on the other hand, relaxes all such kinds of restriction. Note that unlike tree, graph do not have any root node. Rather, every node in the graph can be connected with every other node in the graph. When two nodes are connected via an edge, the two nodes are known as neighbors. So like here, B is neighbor to A, C, D. The advantage of graph is best model real world situations, such as node in the graph may represent a city and the edge connecting the node represent the road. A graph can also be used to represent a computer network where the node are workstations and the edges are the network connections. The disadvantages: some algorithms are slow and very complex. The example is traveling salesman problem and graph coloring. So we have seen some basic data structures. Now we are going to see different operations that can be performed on these data structures. They are traversing, searching, inserting, deleting, merging, and sorting. Now the first operation is traversing. Traversing means it accesses each data item exactly once so that it can be processed. For example, to print the names of all the students in a class. See, another one example I have shown here. So either we can traverse from A to B, B to D, D to H, and then again we can go backtrack and then we can see E to I and I to J. Or else the another way of traversing is you can move from A to B and A to C, and then again you can backtrack, you can move from B to D, D to C. Similarly, we have variety of or different types of traversing is available. The next operation is searching. Searching is used to find the location of one or more data items. So like if you want to find the name of all the students who secured 100 marks in maths, that is, you need to find the location of one or more data item and it can have some constraint. The next one is inserting. Inserting means you need to add new data item to the given list of data item. For example, if you want to add the details of a new student who has recently joined the course. Deleting, it means to remove a particular data item from the given collections of data item. For example, if you want to delete the name of the student who has left the course. The next one is sorting. Sorting means data item can be arranged in some order. Either it may be an ascending order or a descending order, depending on the types of the application. For example, if you want to arrange the name of the student in an alphabetical order. And the last operation is merging. Merging means you are going to combine two shorter data items to form a single list of shorter items. For example, if you want to do two or more operations or apply simultaneously,